Okay, thank you very much. My name is Isabel González and I work as a postdoc in the University of Castilla-La Mancha in the Physical Chemistry Department. My collaborators are the doctors Villalba, Macià, Barón and Valero, and they are from the University of Castilla-La Mancha too. And the title of my present talk is Catalase-like activity of immunoproteins involved on oxidative stress, kinetic study and computer simulations. Firstly, I would like to talk about the production of ROS, or reactive oxygen species. As you know, oxygen is essential for aerobic organisms. Well, this compound can be reduced, producing these radicals, the superoxide radicals, the hydrogen peroxide, or hydroxide radicals, that they are the reactive oxygen species. And they are oxidizing agents able to react with biological molecules, producing in some situations oxidative stress. But what is oxidative stress? Oxidative stress is an imbalance between the accumulation of reactive oxygen species and the ability of the system to reduce them and repair the cellular damage. It's for that that we need all the organism needs some defense mechanisms. But in this work, we are focused on hydrogen peroxide in living organisms. This molecule is very important because play different biological functions. It's an antimicrobial compound, it's a signaling molecule, and it acts in different processes like inflammatory processes. The production of hydrogen peroxide is done by some enzymes, the superoxide dismutase and oxidases, by the reaction you can see in the slide. A low concentration of hydrogen peroxide is necessary for living organisms, but an accumulation is very dangerous. It's for that that there are compounds that eliminate the hydrogen peroxide, like antioxidants, and enzymes and proteins, like hemoproteins. Hemoproteins are metalloproteins containing an imine group. This group is the responsible for the reaction with hydrogen peroxide. And these kind of proteins have different functions in the body, like they are gas transport, electron transfer, and of course, the elimination of hydrogen peroxide. The study of these hemoproteins have different applications. The study of biological metabolism, the oxidation of reducing compounds in the presence of hydrogen peroxide, and they are very used in clinical analysis and sensor development. Well, hydrogen peroxide, in the absence of reducing compounds, reacts with hemoproteins, leading to protein inactivation and oxygen evolution. Hydrogen peroxide is also a suicide substrate for immunoprotein. This is a very interesting process because hydrogen peroxide is necessary for the reaction because it's the substrate, but at the same time inactivates the protein. This process is well known in enzymology and is called suicide inactivation. The action mechanism for suicide inactivation are in the slide, as you can see. As you can see, the substrate reacts with the enzyme, producing the enzymatic intermediates that can evolve towards the formation of the products and the inactivation of the protein. Therefore, the objectives of the present work were the proposition of a general mechanism for the reaction between immunoprotein and hydrogen peroxide in the absence of reducing compounds, the mathematical modelization and simulation using Copassi software, and the validation of the model using mathematical and experimental results. This is the model developed by us for the reaction with of hemoproteins with hydrogen peroxide. This model is general, but it was adapted to the protein hemoglobin. It's important to know that hemoglobin is not an enzyme, but it's a protein, but has different enzymatic activities. And maybe the mechanism is a little complicated, but I'm going to show you only the important aspects. Firstly, As you know, the hydrogen peroxide is necessary to the progress of the reaction because it's needed to produce the enzymatic intermediates, and there are three important processes: the catalase-like activity with the oxygen evolution, the peroxidase-like activity with the production of radical superoxide, and the switch site inactivation, as I told you before. We simulate this model using Copasi software. We introduce all the parameters, the kinetic parameters, the concentration, the reaction, and everything. And this is the system of differential equation. Here you have some examples of some compounds involved on the model. The progression, for example, of the oxygen, the production and consumption of radical superoxide, the consumption of hydrogen peroxide, and some intermediates, enzymatic intermediates. The next step is the validation of the model. We perform the validation of the model by doing some experiment in the lab using the protein hemoglobin and comparing the results on the simulation. On your left, you have the simulations with Copasi, the results, and on your right, you have the experimental results. As you can see, in the oxygen evolution and some kinetic parameters, we obtain similar results, demonstrating that the model is good to describe the behavior of this protein in particular. The same happened with the residual activity. We calculate the residual activity both by simulation and experimentally, and we obtain a similar behavior in the residual activity and some kinetic, the apparent inactivation constants. And finally, we use this model to calculate the parameter R, which is a kinetic parameter that describes the inactivation of the protein and is defined as the number of turnovers of the protein before each inactivation, where we calculate by simulation and by experimental, and we obtain more or less a similar result. It's important to say that this was calculated by hemoglobin, but we can extend and we can calculate for another hemoprotein, such as hoserides peroxidase, ascorbate or ascorbate peroxidase. These results, together with the previous one, demonstrate the goodness of the model proposed to describe the behavior for hemoproteins and in particular for this hemoglobin. Therefore, the conclusion of this work are that we have developed a general model able to simulate the reaction of hemoprotein with hydrogen peroxide in the absence of reducing compounds. The model includes two competitive routes, the catalase-like activity and the peroxidase-like activity. The model includes the switch site inactivation of the protein by hydrogen peroxide, and the simulation of the model are in agreement with experimental data obtained for the protein hemoglobin. This work was supported by this project from the Spanish government. And thank you very much for your attention.
Any questions?
So isn't it a little bit wasteful for the cell? I mean, if I look at this R that you determined for ascorbate peroxidase of 0.6, that would mean that basically, I mean, if you look at the number, how many turnovers you can do before
inactivation. Yes.
So that would mean for one hydrogen peroxide you want to get rid of, waste a full protein. That would be extremely costly for the cell, isn't it?
Yes, the hydrogen peroxide, but in the body we have some reducing compounds that try to avoid this process.
Yeah. I mean, most peroxidases, I'm not sure if all of them, but most of them, also work as NADH oxidases. So I mean, they basically can oxidize NADH and actually do that preferentially over peroxidase functioning. So do you plan to include that?
Yes, this is a genetic study for hemoglobin, but I would like to extend to other proteins. Yes, and it's a way.
Is this inactivation irreversible or reversible?
It's irreversible. Yes. Yeah, because if you remember, you have a time course, and when the...
I can show you.
Here, with the oxygen is constant, more or less, it's because the protein had died. Irreversible, yeah.
And what happened in the cell with such an inactivated levels of cancer? You said...
This is only in this process because there are more processes and more proteins. Maybe there is any other defense mechanism that try to fix this. But this is only the reaction for this protein with hydrogen peroxide. Not taking into account another processes in the cell. It's a kinetic mechanism.
So the experiments you've done then have all been in a test tube solution?
Yeah, sure.
Can you apply your model then to an intact cell system, perhaps by?
It's slightly difficult because you have to put a lot of things in the...
Yeah.
Okay, my experiment consists only I put the hemoglobin and the hydrogen peroxide.
Mm-hmm.
I did different experiments in different conditions, different concentrations, and we developed the model able to describe the behavior of that.
Could you, for example, construct a cell line with hemoglobin construct? Could you construct a cell line with a hemoglobin construct that you could switch on and off and then look at the effects?
With the model, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. And presumably that the system is dependent on iron. Homeostasis too. So
yes.
If you deplete iron, then your hemoproteins will be less active.
Sorry?
So if you deplete iron,
yeah.
The hemoproteins
will be of course. The iron is needed for the reaction because you need the aim group.
Yeah.
Yes, it's the iron with the hydrogen peroxide.
Yes.
And there is different processes. Some of them you reduce the hydrogen peroxide and another oxidase.
Any other questions? No. Okay, well, thank you very much, Maria.